Hi there and welcome back to the Der Grenadier YouTube channel for another video. This one is inspired by a comment that one of you left underneath the last video, and it is a video that is mostly meant for people who are new to reenacting, but it might also be interesting for people who have a little bit of experience in the hobby. And if you do, I would like to know your opinion about this subject and leave it down below in the comments, because this is, again, going to be something that is mostly an opinion of mine about this subject and the way that I see it. This video is going to be about World War II ranks and how they work in a World War II German reenactment. So, by far the most vital and interesting part of German World War II ranks in the hobby of reenacting are the higher ranks. So, for example, NCOs and officer ranks, because you as a beginning reenactor are always going to be something like a grenadier or a schütze, very low down the food chain, and you are going to have to listen to somebody who has a higher rank than you. The people that have a NCO or officer rank are most likely also the people that run the group as a whole, the people that organize events, and the people that have contacts with other groups and events that you are as a reenactor are going to go to. So they are basically like the people that run the whole group. That is in a healthy group, I must add. So these people don't actually outrank you. And that's because the ranks are completely fictional. Well, they are not fictional, they were real. But the NCO that might be above you, the Unteroffizier, for example, is not actually an NCO. And you are not actually a grenadier. You listen to him because that is historically accurate. And because he has an important function in the group, and he takes care of things for the events, and he knows how the event works and what is supposed to happen and what not. And also, he is an NCO because he knows what an NCO did back then. He can give orders, he knows how the orders work, what you must do when he gives you an order, and that's why you listen to him, especially when there is public around. Now, when there is no public around and you're not in a combat situation, it might be the case that your NCO, asks you to do something. For example, get water for the group, get some food for the group, pick up some things, build a fire. He might give you orders like that, but that's not because he wants to play the boss or something like that. That's because there needs to be some kind of basic understanding that he is the group leader. If you only were to do his bidding when he asks you to do something in a combat situation, or when you are doing march or drill, you might not know the difference between when you need to listen to him and when you are not supposed to listen to him. So, when he asks you something, you most likely are going to have to do that. When he asks you to get some water, you listen to him and you get the water. He is, if you have a healthy and good reenacting group, a friend of yours, somebody that you know, maybe from outside of the hobby as well, especially when you have been there for a couple of times and you also have a barbecue with the group from time to time, or a drink in a bar, you get to know him as a friend, and he is not asking you that to play the boss over you. He's asking you that because there needs to be some kind of cohesion between the group, and somebody needs to take the lead also outside of battles and drill. And that's going to be the function of the group leader that is above you. Now, it could also be that the NCO of your group or the group leader is actually somebody who just wants to play that role because he wants to play boss over somebody. That could be the case. If you have the feeling that that is happening, address it to him, because he is not your boss. You are doing something in your spare time that you enjoy, and you should feel safe to talk to him and mention that you don't agree with what he is making you do or how he treats you or something like that. It could also be that a higher ranking soldier from another reenactment unit asks you to do something. And it depends on the kind of event if you actually have to do that yes or no. If it is a display event and you are with multiple groups and somebody with a higher rank asks you to do something and there's no agreement that you have to do that, then you don't have to do it. But there are some types of events where you have a large tactical and all the units agreed that all the ranks are appropriate to give orders to lower ranks no matter what the case is. So in that situation, you also, you have to listen to what another NCO that you might not know is telling you to do because it is a tactical and you are like in the moment and you are trying to reenact something and feel like as if you were a real soldier, then you listen to them. This could also be the case on a display or in a small battle at a display event where an NCO might have to lead over you in the battle, but not outside of the battle. So if he is sitting in a chair on his display and you are walking past and he asks you to get some water for his group, you don't have to do it. But in a battle, if he gives you an order and the agreement is that the ranks are the actual ranks that they were back then and you have to listen to him, you have to follow his orders as well. Might sound pretty obvious, of course. But I have a little diagram on which I'm going to show you how a healthy group works and how a not healthy group works or can work. So this is the situation that I show you right now. You have an event with a display and you have a small battle during that display. You are with three German reenactment groups. You have group one, which is a small reenactment group, which has no officers, no NCOs, does not have a complete Gruppe, and has only a few men, five in this case. Then you have a second reenactment group, which has officers, NCOs for each Gruppe, which is three in total, three Gruppes, with each Gruppe 10, 9, and 10 men. And then you have the last reenactment group, no officer, one NCO, one complete Gruppe with eight men. In a healthy situation, if this is the event that you have, the men from the small group will follow the lead of the officer in battle of the larger reenactment group if all the units and all the people in the units agreed to this. If the small group does not want to follow the orders of the officer in a battle, most likely the group is not going to attend the battle, the group that does not want to conform to the orders of the officer. But if all units agreed, the small group of five men will most likely join the smallest Gruppe, which is going to be the one of group number three. Might sound very straightforward, but this is more or less how it works. Now, we have a second one. And in this case, there is one reenactment group that is doing something wrong. And that's going to be group number one right here. We have one general. Sounds strange, I know, but some groups do this. Then you have two officers, one NCO, and a small group of four enlisted men. There are units that follow structures like this. It's really strange, I know. Then you have a larger group which has no high officer, but a senior NCO or a Unteroffizier mit Portepee for German World War II situations. And then you have two Gruppes with one NCO for each, one group of nine and one group of 10. And then you have a third group, which has no officer as well, no general, nothing special, just an NCO and one Gruppe. It might happen that in a battle, this group wants to participate as well. The general is lazy and sits in a chair. And then you have the two officers who want to command the whole group. They want to be the leaders because they outrank everyone there. If you are one of the people that is in one of these units and you don't agree with that, you can always say, I am not going to follow that man's orders. And if your unteroffizier says that, well, we are going to do that, then you can always say like, oh, then I don't really feel like joining this battle because this is not going to work for me. And that's totally fine as well. If you have a proper reenactment unit, your unteroffizier will not really mind if you don't participate in a battle. That is totally fine to do. But there are groups like this, and there are groups where there are people in there who expect to be have a higher rank over you, and they expect that they can actually give you orders and stuff like that. But they are from a different group, and unless they are like a hosting group on an event where you know from in advance that they are going to have to give you orders and you are going to have to follow them, unless that is the case, you don't have to follow their orders. This could be a lot of information for new or not reenactors, but my advice is, in short, if you don't know what to do or if you don't know how it works or how it's supposed to work, just ask your unit commander. Ask the person that is above you in rank, ask somebody that knows this and see what they think about the subject and what they want you to do and what they expect you to do or not to do. And most likely, they're going to be pretty lenient in most situations because, as I said, they are a friend of yours. And if they are not, you might consider joining a different unit because unless you like almost everyone in the unit, it's not going to be a unit for you. So that's all I have to say, actually. If there are any more questions, please like them down below. If you want to know something that I was not clear on, also ask that. If you have a different opinion or something to add, leave it in the comments. Maybe there's another video that I can make about this subject. And expect more videos with how reenacting works in the future. And I thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Please like, comment, subscribe. And I will see you in the next video.